Suji, the day has come.
Jussi Björling.
Jussi Björling has arrived. One of the most requested singer on our channel since we reacted to Swedish content from like the last 3 weeks. You can see right now all the comments defiling in the bottom. All the people that said since our Hélène Cherholm reaction that we should react to him. He's the king of classical music. Even Luciano Pavarotti.
Yeah.
The maestro has been influenced by him. We're gonna go to his Wikipedia a little bit. He died in 1960. From 1911 to 1960. So he died 63 years ago.
Whoa.
And even that, he's been immensely popular and influenced a lot of the classical tenor, every classical musician that came after him. We're gonna react to O HELGA NATT in Sweden.
Oh,
and as
I
you can see,
it.
Yes. O HELGA NATT. As you can see on screen, I found the best recording of him that we have. There's not a lot of recording of him when we could see him because he died in 1960, so there's not a lot of footage of him.
Mm.
I'm sure there is for other songs, but not for this one. He was regarded as one of the greatest tenor, and even today, many still rate him as the best ever. He has many wonderful recordings, mostly operatic, but also different genres. He died after making the recording of O Holy Night.
Oh.
He suffered a heart attack and died at the age of 49. So this is the song. Yeah, let's get started.
Let's go.
Wow, it sounds so precise, like a doctor that does surgery on the patient, and he's so precise with the movement, his hand don't shake, and he do things so precisely, remind me of like some kind of maestro, but for the song instead.
Yeah, actually, imagine if we have a video about him.
You mean a visual?
Yeah.
Instead of the audio, yeah, but I don't think there is of that song though, I'm not sure. What is he wearing?
Oh, he's also musical theater.
Oh, you know what? My stereotype of the classical singer, they are very big. Because when I heard that he died in a heart attack, I thought that he was going to be like Luciano Pavarotti, like he was going to be more big singer, but he looked quite in good shape. See, Luciano Pavarotti, in 1988 interview for the Swedish daily newspaper, he said, "When I'm about to train a new opera, I first listen to how Jussi Björling did it. His voice was unique and it's path that I want to follow."
Ooh.
I could definitely see the influence in the song. They sing in a very similar style. That was what I was thinking since the beginning. Two very powerful tenor.
Mm.
Attention to all you hold the note, right? I call it tremolo, that little can go out of control. The way that he hold it, the technique is out of this world. Like I need all my brain control to pay attention to everything that he did with his performance. It's unbelievable.
Yes, it's unbelievable. I have the imagination in my head. Yeah, he seemed big, right? But he's not that big.
You mean he's singing in a big way, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Here. so different in every picture. It's as if he was playing like musical theater. Yeah. Like, sure, it reminds me of like the Three Musketeers or something. The way that he slowed down the song, I call that the tension to grab us like in the performance.
Do you know how tall is he?
Wow, it says here his height was unknown.
Huh?
No idea. Well, what do you wanted to say about that?
Oh, because you know when you close your eye, he has a big voice, right? And it's like, he's really huge. Like when you see a lot of character in like Mexico.
So you think that it's gonna be a giant?
Yeah, thing like that. A very big one. When you put some kind of clothes, like royal clothes or whatever in it, it's gonna be like so tall.
And yeah.
Stand like a soldier.
Well, it's unknown, so you can dream that he's tall then. It's up to you. I love that sound that they do in Sweden a lot. Yes, and I was gonna say this sound like All in Night was intentionally going to be sung the style, right? Very like classical. I don't know, just like traditional classical.
Yeah.
Like operatic tenor, like the professional, you know. But it's because I try to pay attention to the sound, right? Like more than the word, to the sound that he create. And it's like a magic almost. It's almost like a magic trick. In like 20 different intonation. I feel like the intonation is changing every 1 minute of the song. It's like it's changing the intonation of the song. Is like giving a almost like a new meaning every time.
Yeah.
Yeah. How Mozart and Beethoven, they are kind of prodigy of the piano, right? How they compose their song, and there seem to be like almost a sense of improvisation. Like he's doing his own thing, and whatever come of his mouth is what come of his mouth. A little bit of an impromptu performance, or like, because some of the best pieces of Beethoven and Mozart were created like by accident almost. Mm-hmm. And I feel like as if this performance was like an accident, like he did it like in a little bit of an impromptu or improvisation, and his voice came out like a magic like this.
Yeah.
When you least expect it, like he didn't have pressure to perform necessarily, like he just did it, you know. I don't know how to explain it. definitely stylish. Look at all the style of the clothes. Some picture, I don't even recognize him compared to the other.
Yeah.
I completely forgot that there was a crowd. It was at a crowd.
Amazing, wow. You still have the style of everything, even just the style. This make you like have a lot of imagination in your head.
Please suggest us more from Jussi Björling. Maybe next time with a video of other songs so we can see what it looked like when he performed, which is also important. That was awesome. I will put another video, I don't know which one here, Swedish musician, singer.